Hello, 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 YouTube family. Okay, today what I'm getting ready to prepare is chicken enchiladas, okay? So, I have my chicken cut up, okay? Can you see that? Okay, so what I'm gonna do first, I'm gonna show y'all all the ingredients in a minute, but what I'm getting ready to do now is I'm getting ready to blend all the things I need for my sauce. I'm gonna move this stuff out the way. Okay. So now, what I'm gonna be blending, let me just kind of turn this around a little bit. There we go. So what I'm gonna be blending is, look at those, green tomatoes. They call it something else, my son said, I can't pronounce it. So here it is, it's green tomatoes. Okay, I'm gonna be blending those, and I'm going to be blending some red onions. You can see the red onion. Well, I'll just lift it up. I'll be blending red onions, and I have a chili here. What did I do with the chili? Oh, here it is. Okay, one chili. Because I don't want it too spicy, but I want it to have a little kick. So I'm going to cut that in half. And I'm going to go ahead and add that to the blender. Go ahead and add that one to the blender. And bring it down a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and add all of my green tomatoes. These are green tomatoes, okay? Uh-oh. Tomatoes left behind now. Okay. And I'm gonna go ahead and add my red onions. And I had some leftover onions from breakfast too. So I'm gonna go ahead and blend those in there, the white onions. Couldn't hurt anything, okay? Now, to get this blended, what I'm gonna be using is this right here. This has basically everything I just put in there, okay? It's a liquid form. I'm gonna use this to help me to blend this up. And this is a chicken enchilada sauce, if you can see that. Okay, so I'm gonna lift that can up and I'm gonna go ahead and pour all of that in here. Okay, and I have an extra one so I can add a little bit more to it. But right now I'm gonna blend this one. And then I'll add it to the skillet when I'm getting ready to mix up my sauce so you guys can see that process too. Okay, come on. I'm gonna blend all this up. This top is on here. Good. Here we go. If it's blended up enough, and it is. Oh my God, this is gonna be perfect, okay? So, like I said, I always keep my little faithful trash bag over here. Now, what I'm getting ready to do is I'm going to move you guys down a little bit more. Because what I'm getting ready to do is I'm going to heat up this skillet. And this is the skillet I'm going to make my sauce in, okay? And I'm going to be adding this along with the other sauce that I have. But first, I've got to prep that, okay? So in order to prep it, I'm going to be needing a stick of butter, okay? So let me get a stick of butter. I need a stick of butter, okay? And I have oil in this already. I'm gonna be adding a little bit of my roasted garlic olive oil. And I wanna say hello to my new subscribers, okay? This is the roasted garlic olive oil. Oh, it is. Okay? And new subscribers, you are welcome. You're welcome. Thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. And I promise you, you stick with me, you won't regret it. Okay? Okay, so I'm letting that get hot. So what I'm going to do is, while that skillet is getting warm, I'm going to come back, and we're going to finish this process. Okay? Here we go. Okay, I am back. So here we go. I'm going to go ahead and add this stick of butter, because it's heated up enough where I can go ahead and do that. I keep little trash bags everywhere, you guys, okay? Now, what I'm getting ready to do is I'm getting ready to put my onions, this is onion, and flour, okay? Now, along with the flour, I'm going to be using some heavy cream, okay? This is the heavy cream that I've chosen. Right here, and it even says it, heavy cream, okay? This is toward making my sauce for my enchiladas, okay? Okay, so now, once this butter melts down, let me get Old Faithful. This is my Old Faithful. I have plenty of these mines right here, okay? Go ahead and just move this butter around so we can go ahead and melt down. And today I got a full day because not only will I be preparing the chicken enchiladas, I'm going to do it step by step. This is the sauce video, okay? This is the beginning stages. I want to get the sauce out the way first, and then I'm going to start working on the tortillas, okay? I'm using corn tortillas, so I'm going to show you that process as well. Like I said, you're welcome, new subscribers. Thank you, guys. And to the person who donated to my channel, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Thank you. It lets me know that you really value what I do. And that's going to help, even that little bit is going to help me even buy seasoning or just some type of ingredients. And it's going to help promote my channel. So if you want to help promote my channel, my Cash App is listed below. And you'll be able to see that. $2, $3. Just enough to buy a onion powder. Or just you know, donate towards promoting my channel, okay? I need your help with this, guys. Because this can get very cost. You know, it can cost. You know, I'm going to continue to do it either way. But it would help for you guys to donate, okay? So here we go. Okay. So now my butter is completely melted down. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move you guys a little bit closer so you guys can kind of see that process. Okay. Here we go. Uh-oh. There we go. So my butter has melted down. Let me get it straight. It's kind of crooked, but here we go. So, the butter has melted down. And what I'm getting ready to do now is I'm getting ready to add my onions. Add all the onions, okay? I'm gonna let that cook for a little bit. I'm gonna let that cook down a little bit. So I just added my butter. And I added my onion. So what I'm going to do, let me get a plate. Because I like to keep a plate over here for my utensils, okay? So I'm gonna let that cook down, let those onions cook down. And then once I let that cook down, I'm gonna go ahead and add my flour. And you guys will see that process as well, okay? I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So I've decided that I need to go ahead and add a little bit of garlic to these with these onions, okay? And I've got all my garlic all cut up. See that? I'm gonna go ahead and just add just a spoon of garlic because I'm gonna be using my garlic for my pasta. I will be showing you guys today, okay? Okay, so that's that. And man, if I tell you it's already smelling good in here, it is already smelling good in here. Okay, so now what I'm getting ready to do is this is like 2 tablespoonful of flour. So I'm gonna add that. It's just 2 tablespoons, okay? Not a lot of flour. I'm gonna go ahead and add just a little bit of the heavy cream, okay? Just a little bit, okay? Just a little bit. I'm pouring it light. It looks like it's a lot, but it's not a lot, you guys, okay? Wanted to make sure that it's going to be thick. I'm going to go ahead and add the rest of this cream. Because remember, I'm making a huge, huge pan of chicken enchiladas. I'm going to go ahead and throw this away. You guys still there? Okay. I'm going to go ahead and mix this in. I need that to cook a little bit. I want it to get thick. There we go. And this is my roux I'm making, okay? I'm making a roux for my chicken enchiladas. now I'm gonna go ahead and pour my sauce that I blended in here. I'm gonna go ahead and move my blender back on the other side by the sink so I can wash it, okay? Just to get it out the way right now. And I'm gonna go ahead and add this other sauce of chicken enchilada sauce. This one I told you guys about. Let me let you see it. That one right there. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and add this to it as well. Okay, this is the sauce that's going to be going on the top of the chicken enchiladas, okay? This is my chicken enchilada sauce that's going on top of the enchiladas once I wrap them, get them in the pan. This is what I'll be pouring on top. So now let me go ahead. I'm going to add a little bit more seasonings to this. I need that to come to a boil. I'm going to go ahead and add this. This is taco sauce, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and add this just a little bit. Just a little bit, okay? Because I'm gonna also be adding that to meat that I'll be cooking, my chicken. Another thing I'm going to be adding to it is garlic and onion powder. Now this is the onion powder? Yeah. It's the onion powder. And you can go in heavy with this, okay? Go in heavy with your onion powder. And then go in heavy with your garlic. I use a lot of garlic. Okay. Now I'm gonna go ahead and trash these cans.
Let me go ahead and add a little bit more of this. And the taco sauce seasoning. Because I really need this to blend a little bit more. Let me get my whisk. There we go. It's getting like a kind of a caramel look. That's what you want. That's exactly what you want. Gotta keep mixing it up. But you gotta remember, we put flour in here, okay? And flour, what it does, it helps the sauce to get thick along with the heavy cream, okay? Helps it to get thick. So can y'all see this process, you know? It's looking good. Down low, and what I want to do now is kind of taste it to see if I need a little, just a little salt, because I'm going to be adding salt to my meat, so I don't want to use too much salt. Oh my God, this is really good. It is really good, you guys. And I am going to add a teaspoon of salt, not too much, okay? We don't want too much. Like that, right there. That's it. just like that right there. Okay, just a little bit of sauce, just salt, just to enhance it. Oh, and let me show you the sauce content I use. I use the chicken bouillon. Chicken bouillon. Okay. Rinse my spoon, and I'm gonna taste it again. Mm. Oh my God, that is good. So I'm gonna go ahead, I can move this. That is going to be the best sauce, okay? All right, you guys. Well, I'm going to let you look at it. There it goes. Does that look good? Okay, so that is the sauce that will be going on top of the enchiladas, okay? So y'all stick with me, and I promise you, I'm going to take you throughout this whole process. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let that cool, right? Then I'm going to start the process for my tortillas, okay? Be right back. Okay, you guys, I am back. I am back. Okay, so now I'm getting ready to soften up these tortillas. And the tortillas that I'm using are these. You see them? Can you see them? Wait a minute. There we go. That's what we're using, okay? It's missing tortillas. Missing tortillas, okay? Okay, so now I'm gonna soften these up. And I'm grabbing it with the grabs, okay? Because all I wanna do is just run it in the grease and take them out. Oh, that's not a good one. I'm gonna throw that one away. Okay. Let's just run them in the grease and pull them out. That's all you do. Oh shoot, it's my grabs that's doing this. Okay. Let's see. I saw a lady doing this. And she was pulling them out. Okay. I think that's how I'm gonna have to do it. Because my grabs is tearing them up, you guys. So, I'm going to run them in the grease. Pull them out. Don't do this if you're not used to doing this, okay? I'm used to dealing with grease, so. You don't want them to fry. You just want them to soften up. And these are corn tortillas, okay? You just want them soften up where you can wrap them, okay? Want them soft enough where you can wrap them. You can wrap all the chicken, the vegetables, the cheese, everything in it. Okay? That's basically what you're gonna do. Just gonna do them like this, do them like that. Just to get them soft enough where you can wrap them. And to be honest with you, these Nissin tortillas, they pretty soft. So, what you don't want them to do is fry, okay? You just want them soft enough to wrap. I like corn tortillas because they taste better when it comes to enchiladas, okay? They do, they taste a lot better when it comes to enchiladas. Okay. Just take your hand, run it through the grease, run it back, and then back again, and then take them out. Like I said, if you're not used to doing this, don't do it. I'm gonna go ahead and remove this one. And I'm gonna remove this one here too as well. If I can grab this out of here with my breath. I hate a dirty stove when I'm cooking. Hold on. I don't like a dirty stove when I'm cooking, so we're gonna pull this stove out of here. Okay. Ooh. Okay, I'll get it. Okay, here we go. Be careful. Be really careful when you're doing this. Basically, all I want to do is just soften them up so I can wrap them. And I'm doing a huge pan of enchiladas, okay, of chicken enchiladas, so. Probably gonna use almost all of this. I thought the grabs would be a better choice, but it wasn't. And like I said, basically what you're doing, you just soften them up so that you can go ahead and wrap these. And I have the fire on a very, very low heat because you don't want these to fry. You know, this is actually what they use to make the tortilla chips. Okay, oh shit. That one I dropped, okay? I wonder if I can use that. Yeah, there we go. Again, you guys, look at that. I'm telling you, you gotta have Old Faithful in your kitchen. Got to have an Old Faithful, someone that you can depend on when it comes to your utensils, because I'm telling you, it really does matter. I'm just calculating how many of these I'm gonna need. I'm not for sure about them yet, but hey, we'll see. If I have to do some more, I will. Because I'm doing, like I said, I'm doing a full pan. Like I said, I have the heat on a really low heat because I don't want them to fry. I just want them to soften up, okay? So all I need for them to do is just soften up. Okay, you guys, so I'm going to finish this process with these tortillas, and then I'm going to come back, okay? All right. Okay, you guys, I am back. So I've got the tortillas finished, okay? So I'm kind of going to give you a kind of a look. I'm going to drain some of this oil off of it, too. And use this oil. Hold on, bear with me here. I got the tortillas ready. I want y'all to see what I was looking for. See how soft that is? That's what you want when you're doing the tortillas in the oil. You just want them soft enough where you can wrap them in your meat, okay? So I'm gonna put these over here to the side. What I'm getting ready to do now is I'm getting ready to put my chicken in, okay? Of course, you know what I use. We'll just get this on because I want it to start getting hot. What I use, put my shirt down in the back. What I use is the roasted garlic olive oil to cook my chicken. And I'm telling you guys, it's a lot of chicken, okay? And once this gets hot, you guys, then I will be back and you will see me cooking the chicken and the seasonings that I'm gonna put in my chicken, okay? So I'll be right back. Uh-oh, here we go. I'm back, you guys. Now I got my chicken on, okay? Got my chicken on. And now I'm getting ready to, as soon as this chicken cook a little bit down, okay? And it's a lot of it, okay? I don't know if you can see that, but it's a lot of chicken, okay? So now, once I cook this chicken down, once I cook it down, then I'm gonna season it. But I need it to cook a little bit more first. You know what? I think I'm gonna go ahead and try to season it, okay? I'm gonna turn my fire up a little bit so we can go ahead and start cooking. And let's see. All my seasonings are in here, babe. I keep a lot of seasonings in here. Mostly, I try to keep a lot of my foreign seasonings. Let's check. Let's talk about seasoning there. What I'm gonna be using to season my meat is gonna be this. It's a taco seasoning, okay? That's what I'm gonna use to season my meat, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and sprinkle this seasoning around in here. And remember, taco seasoning has salt, so you do not want to add salt at all, okay? Taco seasoning does have salt, so you don't want to add it, okay? I want my meat to be flavorful. When I wrap them up, I want it to have flavor, okay? Okay. Mm-hmm. And being that this, I added two packages, but being that this is such a large, it's large, okay?
Then I'm gonna go ahead and add one more package. So I'm gonna do total three packages of taco seasoning.
Like I said, it has salt in it, so you don't wanna add salt. You may add a little black pepper, which I'm gonna do. I will be adding black pepper to this. Like I said, I love my black pepper. Then I'm gonna go ahead and mix that in. Now, everybody can do their chicken enchiladas the way they want to do them. This is how I do them, okay? So if you're Hispanic or Latino, don't judge me, okay? This is the way I do it, okay? I'm gonna make sure I mix all this taco seasoning in really, really good, okay? Like I said, I like for my enchiladas to have flavor, okay? Now what I'm gonna add to it is some garlic and onion powder. Like I said, I love garlic and garlic loves me, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead. Much garlic as you want to add, because garlic is healthy for you, you guys. Okay? And I add a lot. And onion powder, okay? And remember, the sauce is seasoned perfect, so, and it's gonna go on top of this. So you just kinda wanna not use too much salt, and like, you know, if you have high blood pressure, you wanna kinda stay away from the salt as much as possible, okay? So now, this is all mixed in really good. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put a lid over it, let it cook. I'm gonna wash off my faithful. If I tell you, this girl has been faithful to me for years. She has been faithful to me for years. I've always used the wooden spoon, I love it. It makes life so much easier. So now I'm gonna put the lid over it. And I'm gonna let that cook, okay? I'm gonna let it cook. I'm gonna put it on a medium high because I want it to cook slow, okay? Put that on a medium high. And let me go ahead and throw all this stuff right here away. And I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what I'll be wrapping my tortillas in, okay? So I didn't feel like cutting up tomatoes, right? So what I decided to do was, I'm gonna drain this too. Hold on, let me drain this. So what I decided to do is I'm gonna use the tomatoes, and I found that when you use Rotel tomatoes, it just gives it such, oh, excuse me, a lot of seasoning, okay? A lot of seasoning's going on in this kitchen right now. And I have a tendency to sneeze whenever I'm using seasoning. So what I decided to do is to use these two things right here.
I'm using this huge can of Rotel tomatoes. And this one right here. This was the Kroger's brand. Okay, this is the Kroger brand. I told you each store has their own brand. And these have chilies in it, okay? So that's what I'm using. I'm gonna use that as the tomato part to wrap my, excuse me, I gotta sneeze again. Hold on. Ooh, I thought I did. I guess I didn't, okay. So I'm gonna use these tomatoes along with my blended. This is onions, it's onions, white onions, red, yellow, orange, and green bell peppers, okay? I'm gonna use that, and I'm also gonna put some of this on top of it. Okay, the cheese that I will be using is the Mexican blend, okay? I'm using the Mexican blend cheese, okay? And I'll also be using this as well to wrap my tortillas in, okay? So. Right now, I'm gonna keep them in the refrigerator so I'm ready to start wrapping them. I'm gonna be using some cheddar cheese. See here? Sharp cheddar. I'm using some cheddar cheese. So, I'm gonna use this on the inside of the tortillas as well as the outside of the tortillas. And I have two of those. So, it's gonna be a very cheesy, very cheesy meal. It's gonna be a good meal. I want y'all to just stick with me throughout this process. And we're gonna get this done. And you know what? I also bought me this right here. You see this? You know, I gotta have my jalapenos. If I can't spice it up too much, I can eat this on the side with it, okay? And I'm gonna go ahead and put the, hold on, I wanna do something, hold on. Okay, you guys, I was thinking about adding that taco sauce, the one right here, but, and this is my first time ever using it. I might try this with it, and you can buy it on the shelf just like this. They don't freeze it, it's a liquid. You can buy it just like that. I was gonna add that to my meat. Mm-mm. It's got a vinegar taste to it that I don't really care for the enchiladas. It's kind of throwing the taste off a little bit. So I was like, you know what? I'm not doing that. And I'm telling you something, guys. If you know food, and I'm telling you, I know my food, okay? Let me move these around a little bit. Starting to cook. I know food. And when something tastes off to me, I'm can I use it? Can I not use it? On this case, not, okay? Just stick with the taco seasoning in the packages, okay? That's gonna be your best bet, is just to stick with that, okay? Mm. Okay. All right. So, you guys, I'm gonna be right back.
I'm gonna let that cook for a little bit, and I'll be back. I'm back, you guys, okay.
So I want my chicken to be a little bit shredded, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I've added them to the blender. If I can't blend them down, okay? Down a little bit. I'm gonna add a little bit.
I want it to be a little bit blended, okay? Okay, I'm gonna have to add something to it. So bear with me here, you guys, okay? I'll be right back. Okay, don't do that. It turned it more into a puree. So I need a food processor for that, okay? So I can do what I wanna do on that one. Okay, and I'm gonna invest in that for real, for real. Okay, so now but it is gonna be still good, okay? Didn't mess it up. I just need to let this cook so that it can really give me what I need, okay? So I'm gonna let that cook for a little bit. And you guys, I will be back, okay? Ugh, why did I do that? I was doing good until I did that one, okay? But we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna put these enchiladas together. And we'll see how this turns out, okay? Okay. Okay, you guys, I'm back. So I just added this, a package of chili powder to my meat, okay? So I'm gonna give y'all a look at what the meat is. Some of it is blended, some of it is whole. So I need for it to cook a little bit longer, okay? And here we go. Okay, here we go. So you see that? That is what I'm going to use to stuff my tortillas, okay? And it's looking good. So, I was trying to like shred the chicken without having to go through the process of shredding it. That didn't work out. So I'm gonna leave that, okay? Next time I will just go through the process of shredding it. But this is gonna turn out good too. So, I add the chili powder because I want the enchilada flavor, okay? So, just bear with me here. I promise you guys, I'll be right back. Like I said, my tortillas is ready. I just need this meat. This is chicken, so I need to just cook down a little bit more. I wanted to make sure it's tender. So when I wrap it and I put the cheese and everything in it, you'll see that process, okay? So bear with me. Okay, I know this is a long process, but those are the kind of meals that I prepare, okay? And like I said, like, share, subscribe to my channel, okay? Share it out to your friends, okay? And donate to my channel. I don't care if it's just $2. My Cash App information is below, okay? Any little thing that you can donate to help me to support my channel will help, okay? Like, someone donated, it was a small amount, but it meant so much to me because now I could go and buy that extra seasoning that I need or that extra package of meat that I need to support my channel. Giving y'all this content doesn't come free, okay? It comes out of my pocket, but I want y'all to see the process because this is something I love. Uh-oh,
hold on. Over a little bit. There we go.
So this is something I love to do. This is my passion. So help support my passion. Donate $2 or $3. It's all it takes. So I'll be back in a minute, you guys. Okay, you guys, I am back and it's time to do my tortillas and put my enchiladas together. What I have here is some cheddar cheese. So I'm gonna grab one of the tortillas. Let me get a spoon here. Here we go. I'm gonna use this one. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up in here, mix it in. And I'm gonna take a little bit of the meat. Along with a little bit of the cheddar cheese. I'm gonna take some of the onions. I should've got bigger tortillas, okay?
and a little of the tomatoes, just a little bit. That I'm gonna take and take my time and wrap these. There we go. And I'm gonna push it over in the corner like that. Now I'm gonna fill this whole pan, okay? Okay. I might have too much meat here. I might end up with two pans, you guys. What it's looking like. Good. Wash my hands, you guys. Okay. I'm gonna take a little bit of the cheddar cheese. Sprinkle that on top. Some of the onions and bell peppers, sprinkle that in there, and a little bit of the tomatoes. Because remember, now we're going to use these on top too. Push that in. We're going to take this. Still a little hot, you guys, so I'm trying to wrap them the best way I can with them being hot. Okay, there we go. Remember, this is gonna go in the oven too, you guys, okay?